and seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
Hey, I'm Willie Nelson, and you're watching Hip Rock TV.
We don't run, and we don't compromise. We don't quit, we never do.
Attention, Michigan veterans. I am S. Sergeant Tony Vance, Senior Advisor for Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access. We are working with the state legislature to create a program to help veterans pay for their medical cannabis needs. We need your help. Contact me at 517-224-9037. Don't wait. Come help us.
Hi, I'm Willie Nelson, and the Willie Nelson Teapot Party and I endorse Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access.
Hello, ladies and germs. I am Master Sergeant Tony Vance, the voice of Freedom's Voice. Tonight, let's talk about Donnie Indicted. I noticed one thing right away when they printed his mugshot, that they had his convict number underneath the picture. And it was 1135809. And it struck me. What's that song, 867-5309? Is that it? I don't know. I'm not sure. 1135809. I can't help but laugh. I'm sorry. You should never laugh at another's downfall. But he'll get a fair trial. That's more than he would himself probably give most people. If you paid any attention, all the people surrounding him have all either gone to jail or been indicted or been thrown under the bus by him. He's running out of lawyers. They won't work for him. That's got to tell you something, you know? So anyway, there's that. But I couldn't help. 1135809. Yeah. That's perfect. Unless they wrote that on purpose, I don't know. I don't think so. That was the number that come up. You know, because they're treating just like everybody else. I'll give them credit for that. He's being treated no worse or no better than anybody else that has come in and, you know, be arrested and booked and go through the whole nine yards, you know. If you're indicted, you're indicted, you know. They must have something. They don't just indict you for nothing. There must be some evidence that leads them to believe that you did what they think you did. So you'll get a fair day in court to defend yourself and say, no, I didn't do that. And prove that you didn't do it. And that'll be that. Done. I swear, though, don't anybody be offended, but way back in the beginning when he come down the golden escalator, I knew about him in New York City. I knew that he would do crap like he would call a radio station and pretend to be somebody else. And talk about how wonderful Donald Trump was about this or about that. And the craziness about it, because you knew it was his voice. There's no way of hiding his voice. It was him. Add that, and I see him coming down the golden escalator, and I go like, we're in for trouble. And we were. The people, you and me, all of us together, God bless our black, flabby little hearts, we gave Obama, after the first 2 years, we gave him a Republican Congress, which didn't allow him to accomplish anything. Even cheated him out of assigning a Supreme Court justice by holding it open until the election, as McConnell did that. Pay attention to all this. It will show you that the Republican Party, the way it is now, is not afraid to cheat, lie, and do whatever it takes to win. Morality, integrity, got nothing to do with it. All they want to do is win, win, win. And you don't even know why they want to win. Why do they want to win? Do they want to win to increase Social Security by $200 a month? Hell no, they want to get rid of Social Security. So, you know, they're crazy to begin with. I'm actually reading the Oxford History of the United States, the part from 1929 until 1949. Okay? The war year, 49, yeah. The war years and all that. And I've just read the part where they had to, all the crap they had to go through to get Social Security established and everything, and to keep the Supreme Court from knocking it down and all that stuff. Right? It wasn't easy. But, you know, it was always the Republican Party that opposed that kind of thing from the very beginning. And I don't know why. Now, when it came to Reagan, it was a real simple process. You know, they give me enough money to get reelected. I get reelected. I propose tax cuts aimed at mostly at the wealthy. They get the tax cuts. They're so grateful. The next time I come up for reelection, they support me. I get reelected and repeat. And that's been going on since Reagan. Every time the Republicans get elected, huge tax cuts for the wealthy. And if you know anything about trickle-down economics, all you have to do is listen to what Will Rogers said. You give the money to a poor man, and a rich man will have it in 24 hours. But at least the poor man would have got some use out of it. But we don't do that. Or the Republicans don't do that. They give it to the already wealthy. And they say, well, it dusted. But anyway, Donnie's been indicted. And he's probably going to be the choice to be president. And it's going to be interesting as hell if he gets 12 years, if he's going to rule from jail. I think, though, all you have to do is pay attention to the 14th Amendment. All right. 14th Amendment actually says he's not eligible, especially if he's convicted. But he participated in an insurrection, and that makes him ineligible. He broke his oath to protect and defend the Constitution. That's all it's all about. You know, all it's all about. 1-1-3-5-8-0-9. The thing about Georgia, even if he gets elected president, he can't get pardoned, and the governor of Georgia can't pardon him. So they're in the process of trying some trick to get rid of Fannie Willis. The legislature gave themselves some kind of power they can get rid of a prosecutor they don't like. See? So in October, they're coming after her. All to protect a crook and con artist because they can't admit they were conned. That's it. You have these people so into it. I know it's heartbreaking. I've admitted I thought for sure that was it, but it wasn't. How disappointing. Move on. Right? It's not that you can be wrong about something. It's that once you realize you're wrong, you change, admit you were wrong, and change your opinion or whatever the hell it is you were talking about. 1-1-3-5-8-0-9. Okay, that's it. All right. I got a cancer treatment in the morning. My hair's still gone. My cancer is dormant, like I told you the last time. So y'all have a good time the rest of the weekend. And I'll see you next time.
Hi, I'm Willie Nelson, and the Willie Nelson Teapot Party and I endorse Veterans for Medical Cannabis Access.
You throw me up and smoke me when I die.
Hey, I'm Willie Nelson, and you're watching Hemp Rock TV.